Vinyl community, welcome back. Here we are. Welcome to the Sunday afternoon recovery session for me. I had a really big night yesterday. I had a friend over. I spent lots and lots of records. Had a really good night, had a really big night. One of the things I was playing to my friend who hadn't heard this before last night was this record here. And this is a Liberty Press that I had bought many, many years ago, and I've always loved it, but it kind of blew us both away all over again, how good it is. I'm playing again this morning because, just absolutely fantastic. This is About to Get a Tone Poet reissue, or it's just happened. This one sounds amazing, so I don't know what the Tone Poet will be like, but I would imagine it's top notch. But yeah, I love this record, Next to Autumn One, Flat Up. Really, really cool. Okay, so we'll start off with this wonderful, wonderful reissue here of Katanga, which I'm now really happy to hold in my hands. This originally came out in 1963 on Pacific Jazz, and this is the 2021 Tone Poet reissue. Now, I remember learning about this record many years ago from, I'm pretty sure it was Sepa Funk back in the day, talked about it showing his original. And he also showed around the same time that Kawaida record. I'll put a little thing here so you know what I'm talking about. And I always kind of got them confused or put them together. When I saw this was getting reissued, I was really excited because I think it's very expensive to get clear and original. I knew how great this was. It's one of those tone poets that I guess, I don't know what it's like around the world, but my local store has been getting each of them in pretty consistently. And they usually get about five in them, they usually all go eventually. So they're semi-easy to get, but this one, apparently they got 10 copies in and they sold out straight away. Which really surprised me. I guess this is one of the in-demand ones. For obvious reasons, this is an absolutely fantastic jazz record. It's really, really great. The guitar playing is really, really wonderful, and the bass playing is really, really wonderful. Obviously being on Pacific Jazz from the West Coast, not really an East Coast jazz record, it kind of adds a little bit of something different to it. I don't know how to describe it, just really, really top quality jazz. The trumpet, it goes from sort of groovy, upbeat, there's modal bits in here, there's really reflective, quiet passages. It's really fantastic. It's like one of the best non-Blue Notes jazz records, I reckon. Katanga, and look at that wonderful cover. Super great. Sorry, I'm not really feeling very particularly excitable today, I guess. I am in recovery mode. I'm really happy they put that out. That's what I love what Tone Poet have been doing, and putting out some kind of more interesting releases by Blue Note artists or things like this, putting out this on Pacific Jazz, and they put out the Money Jungle reissue, which was on Pacific Jazz as well, I'm pretty sure. It's kind of exciting. The next one is a Record Store Day purchase of a Record Store Day release. It's the only thing I wanted out of all two Record Store Days, basically. And I haven't seen anyone else pick this up or talk about it. I'm really surprised about that. It's this record here. So this is the 2021 reissue of a 1987 album called Dance by Kamal Abdul Aleem, or on the back as it says, Kamal and the Brothers. This is a record that quite a few years ago there was a post going around about sort of the best 80s jazz records, and this was always up there on top of the list, so I remember taking note of it back then, and I knew I'd probably never get an original. They're very expensive, so I was really, really surprised to see this was even being put out for Record Store Day. And I kind of thought to myself, oh, there's no way people in New Zealand, anyone's going to ever have this. I kind of thought I'll have to wait and probably pay too much on Discogs for it. But weirdly enough, one of the stores in Auckland that I know quite well said they've got a couple of copies in, and they'll save one for me. So I was really happy to finally get a copy. Yeah, this is really amazing. It's more like a soul jazz album, I guess, with like funky, groovy parts. It's lots of really beautiful flute playing. It sounds like it could be a black jazz record, to be honest, or it has a really nice groovy feel to it. The thing that caught my attention, there was a big draw card, is James Spalding plays flute on here, and I am a really big James Spalding fan. I think he's very underrated. There's an amazing video by Sherv. He did it maybe a year or two ago now, probably a year ago, about James Spalding. It's really great. If you can check that out, if you want to know more about him. He, the stuff he does on here is absolutely beautiful. And then probably the other name that people would know would be Idris Muhammad on drums. But apart from that, it's people I've never heard of before. Apart from that, it's really, I think this is really, really good. Like, I don't know, I thought there'd be more people picking this up. Or maybe I'm just watching the wrong YouTube channels these days. Super great. This is number 23. I don't know how many were made, put out by Passion Music in the UK. Yeah, super great. I should do a little bit of a warning. There is some quite 80s sounding bits and pieces and production elements here and there. But if you can look beyond that, this is absolute gold, I think. Yeah, worth checking out, definitely. So yeah, 1987 jazz, the year I was born. Yeah, I was really happy that was being reissued. It was kind of a really strange thing. Okay, we're going to move on to 1975. And what we have here is the third album by Burning Spear, probably an album you all know, an album that I know very well inside out from listening online throughout the years. I was really happy to get a Jamaican pressing of this, which just first off the bat sounds absolutely incredible. This is his third album. It's very militant, very political. I don't think he fully went into Rastafarianism, but he took a lot of the beliefs and elements and mixed it in with this sort of really political, heavy sound, I guess. It's a very, like, for me, it sounds very, like, dry, a very percussive, a very heavy. It's obviously an absolute classic Jamaican record. It's truly wonderful. I don't blame to speak too much to it. My copy has this really cool, like, custom label that I've never seen before. It's listed as unknown on Discogs, but it's got a Tuff Gong sticker on the back. So who knows? But either way, it sounds really, really fantastic. I picked this up online, and weirdly, coincidentally, at the time, I was listening to a podcast that I can really recommend. It's not a music podcast, but it's called 99% Invisible. And it's all about how design, whether that be, you know, graphic design, industrial design, they were talking about the way our lives are designed and how it affects our everyday lives. And a couple of weeks ago was International Flag Week, which, yes, is a thing. And there was an episode based around the green, black and red flag, which is a flag that was invented by Marcus Garvey, the philosopher and, I guess, political philosopher of black rights. He sort of introduced the concept of Pan-Africanism and the idea of every black person's home being Africa. And he also invented the Black Star Line, which I had always known vaguely about and referenced in the Mos Def album, and a few other things, but I never heard properly. Anyway, so I was listening to all this and I was kind of learning as I was going, and weirdly I kind of absentmindedly checked one of my local spots online that has stuff, and they had this album there right as I was listening to this thing on Marcus Garvey. It was really strange, so I grabbed it straight away. It was good timing, but yeah, I don't know. And I also managed to pick up this from the same seller at the same spot, the dub version, which is really incredible. It's kind of like, it's definitely obviously dubbed, but they don't go fully dubbed. There's still a lot of chunks left in there and it doesn't feel completely far out. But it's really amazing. The track that absolutely blows my mind on here is the third track, which is a dubbed version of Black Wadada. Just the way it drops and grooves and the way the percussion hits is really, really, really wonderful. But yeah, this is Garvey's Ghost. So this is came out the same year on, this one's on UK Island Pressing. Classic reggae. I'm really happy to kind of fill that gap, I guess, in the collection. Been wearing those for a very long time. Okay, the next one is kind of, I went out with my girlfriend to a record fair out basically an hour and a bit north of here in a really sort of small rural town. And kind of I had low expectations, but I thought I should go just in case. It's kind of a nice day trip out there. And I found a record that probably to most people here might not be a big deal, but for me it's kind of a big deal because I've never seen a copy before, and this is a compilation here of New Zealand electronic music. I'm pretty sure the only person that I've spoken to about this who isn't from New Zealand in the vinyl community is Chris Cole, who knows all about this, and I'm sure he knows how great this is. I think he's asked me to look out for a copy for him, but I've only just found a copy for myself. But if I do find a second copy, that's for you, Chris. Absolutely. I managed to find this for an amazing price up there. It wasn't like dirt cheap or anything, but I was really happy. And it kind of goes for kind of stupid amounts of money on the internet these days, and I've always been very reluctant to pay what that is. So yeah, I was really happy to get that at a normal price. Now, what is this? It is an amazing collection of early, early electronic avant-garde music, concrete New Zealand stuff. So a lot of the stuff you can't get outside of this compilation. It's a 3LP box that was released in New Zealand in, 75, is that right? Yeah, another thing from 1975. Yeah, 1975, recorded just down the road here at Victoria University in Wellington. Comes with this really beautiful booklet here. I was kind of a little bit worried about this, that it would just be a sequence of sort of like bleepy-bloopy. Like, I kind of thought it would sound like this for three LPs, which is a very tough listen, a very engaging listen, but doesn't. It's very varied. There's lots of sound dialogue, soundscapey things going on, lots of layering, lots of mood pieces. It's a really interesting sort of New Zealand artifact of experimental music in the country. Obviously, later on, as we got into the 90s and stuff, this is kind of a bit of a textbook for bands like the Dead Sea messing around, especially the first side. It sounds really heavy, and yeah, I can almost hear little bits of Dead Sea if I put my mind to it. So as an artifact, it's you know, the New Zealand electronic jazz release. I think this was released, reissued on tape a few years ago. I think if you look on Sound, it's still up there, the website. But yeah, this is three LPs. The second two discs, I'm pretty sure, are unplayed. It's like the first side, which is all Douglas Lilburn stuff, is absolutely amazing and worth the price alone. That's the label there. I have to admit, I think around the second half of side two, there's one track called something like, it's called Christmas Music, something like that, and I had to turn it off because it was driving me nuts. It sounded like when something is glitching when it's streaming and it kind of just goes and stutters, and that just really triggered me, and I had to switch it off. And then by the third LP, I have to admit, my mind was kind of drifting a little bit and I found it hard to focus. It's definitely not an easy listening, it's cool to have it, and it's something I had never seen before, so it's definitely a unique piece in the collection. So there we go. That is my Vinyl Finds 132. That's all. I'm gonna go chill out now, listen to some more records, edit this video, and just relax. I don't know. That's all I have to say. Cool. What are we on? About 20 minutes. It's pretty good. See ya.